And we're back. all right. sorry. Thanks very much. We're going to call the order. The Committee of the Whole is now called to order. The time is 6:50. Any disclosures of pecuniary interest? This one? Nope. And I've received none in advance. So we're going to move on to delegations, and we have one delegation tonight that is with Darla Price, Northumberland Manufacturers Association, regarding how it's made Northumberland Manufacturers Open House for April 22nd, 2023. Hello.
Hello. Thank you so much for the opportunity to speak this evening and present to you. For those that don't know much about us, we are the Northumberland Manufacturers Association. We are a nonprofit organization physically located in Cobourg, and we represent approximately 50 manufacturers from across Northumberland County, 8 of those manufacturers located here in Port Hope. We also represent 45 what we call associate members, and those are businesses that are actually within our supply chain. So I'm excited to share that this year, our directors have decided to have a focus and a goal on community engagement. It's about bringing people in, sharing what we make and what we do here in the county. So to kick it off, we would like to introduce to you how it's made. Northumberland Manufacturers Open House on April 22nd, brought to you by, of course, our association and Northumberland County. There we go. Sorry about that. Maybe power? Okay, very good. Thank you. What is How It's Made? It is a one-day event where two manufacturers from select Northumberland towns will open their doors to share what is made in the county and how it's done. Our target audience is ages 10 and over, which includes parents, youth, retirees, and of course, we're hoping and praying lots of job seekers. The purpose of this event, as I mentioned, is to engage our community. We want to show our general community our career opportunities. We want to talk about our wages. We want to talk about the skill sets and what's needed to work in the industry. We want to engage our mature community members. We have found over the past 5 years, individuals who are retired or semi-retired who have moved into our community come with skills and wealth. And we have found over the past 5 years, we've had individuals actually become mentors. They've invested in some of our startup, and we're looking to engage and further bring out more of those individuals to check out what we're up to and create some pride around the industry. We want to share our philanthropy. We want to talk about that we are great corporate citizens, and we're looking to remove the stigma of the industry. As I've mentioned many times before, this isn't Grandpa's shop anymore. We're not dirty, unsafe, unpredictable work, but instead we want to show you the innovations, the things that we have done to put in place to make sure our people are safe and healthy. And of course, to show how we globally or how we impact locally for the things that we do and produce for the global the global consumer. Overall, we're looking to build a sense of pride. We want our community to be proud and to know that it's okay that we have a strong industrial base. We are here to share your tax burden, and we're here to help support you and us having a healthy and sustainable environment. And as one of the largest employers across the county, we are very, very proud of our people, what they do and how they work each day. And we want the community to come out and meet our teams, share in the pride of what we do together and the amazing things we produce in our county. Next slide. Here is the current participating manufacturers. Of course, we have Port Hope, couldn't leave you out, Coburg and Campbellford. The event is on a Saturday, April 22nd. It is from 10 till 2. We are also hosting a free barbecue in each of the communities at one of the particular manufacturers. And this is open from noon to 1 for the general community. I would like to edit the URL that you see there. Our event URL is now howitsmadenorthumberland.ca. And we encourage potential guests and the community to visit that URL, as there's going to be a lot guests need to know before they arrive. When you take tours through the manufacturers, there's going to be PPE that's going to be needed to be placed, and cell phones put aside, and the whole bit. Yeah, we're excited. Okay, next slide. So our ask of you tonight, we want you to share this event with your community. Talk about it, invite your network, and we'd like you to attend. We've got the opportunity, we can flip burgers, help with the ketchup, register people, help guests with their PPE. We would love for you to be there. It's very important that our leadership is there, just as proud as we are, and taking part in the activities. We'd like access to your marketing or communications department. So we'd like to be able to promote to your general population. So whether that's social media, flyers at the rec center, whatever it may be, we would like for you to include us. Provide picnic tables. I actually probably could have taken this off, because you are, as I have visited every council and spoken with every town across the county, Port Hope was the first with Miss Jeannie Maidens jumping on board. Yes, Darla, we've got tables, no problem. Yes, we're going to waive the fees for you. And what else and how else can we possibly get involved? So I can take that ask off because you are already providing that for us. And we thank you very, very much. And of course, our last piece is we're open to ideas on how the town can take part. Economic development, table at the manufacturers, staff, people being there to mix and mingle. And that is it. I welcome you all to join us on the day of. Thank you so much for the opportunity.
Wonderful. Thank you very much. I think we have some questions. Councillor Claire.
I think it sounds amazing, and I'm sure my boys would be very interested. My only concern is the fact that the event is being planned on Earth Day, which may result in some difficulty scheduling conflicts and people trying to be in many places at once, because I know there's a lot of community events and things that will be happening around Earth Day as well. That said, I think it sounds really interesting, and I hope that you get a good crowd.
We actually do know it's Earth Day, and we've got a couple of our manufacturers who, so for example, Mermill and Campbellford and Graphic Packaging, because they deal with wood, paper packaging, they will be giving out all guests little tree saplings in their paper cups to go out and plant around their communities. So, but I understand. Fingers crossed, right?
Very cool. Councillor Collins.
Yeah, outstanding. Thank you. So the three municipalities advertised to date, Port Hope, Coburg, Campbellford, each municipality is going to have two from each municipality. Is that correct? And we have not decided yet at this stage which companies or manufacturers in Port Hope are going to be the focus for the barbecue, is that correct?
So the two companies that were listed on the last slide, we have Trade Tech Industries and CPK Interiors. Both of those locations are the manufacturers in Port Hope that will be open for touring and guest visits. The barbecue itself will be located at Trade Tech within their parking lot in Grassy area. Yes.
Other questions? Wonderful. Sounds exciting. Thanks so much for coming forward and bringing it to our attention. Recommended action identified on the agenda is to receive this presentation for information. Would a member of council like to move? Moved by Councillor Less and seconded by Councillor Mink. All in favor? Great. Thanks very much. We are. Thanks, Brian. We're going to move along to consent agenda. Tonight, we have several items under the consent agenda. Items listed under the consent agenda are considered collectively as one motion. Council members are welcome to request that a specific item be removed for a separate discussion and deliberation or action. Would anyone like to remove any one of those action items? Yes, Councillor Mink?
Thank you. I would like to pull 4.2.
4.2, thank you. And members of council, any other items you want pulled from this? Okay. So what I will do then is, Councillor Mink, we'll come back to 4.2. We'll just do the rest. So what I'd like to do is we'll take 4.1, 4.3, 4.4, 4.5, 4.6, and 4.7. And we will... ask for a mover and a seconder to receive those as information. We'll come back to 4.2. Can I get a mover that we move that? Moved by Councillor Less, seconded by Councillor Collins. All in favor? And so moved. So then let's open up 4.2, which is the Heritage Port Hope Advisory Committee meeting minutes of January 16th, 2023. Councillor Mink?
Thank you. So through the chair, I just wanted to talk about seven new business. There's some discussion here about doing some type of research on this historical streetscape of Mill Street and Queen Street, I believe. This is coming to me as a surprise through the minutes of a committee. Typically, this comes. It's directed by council as a council referral to the committee. So it just is, I don't know anything about this. So I'm wondering if someone could please speak to what this is, the objective of this, and how it came to be in this process.
Certainly. Todd, did you want to speak?
Sure, I'm happy to speak to this matter briefly. So as you'll notice in the minutes, this was a request from the mayor to a member of the committee, Rod Stewart. It didn't come through staff. So it came up at the meeting. The mayor, described by committee member Stewart, that the mayor wanted to take a proactive approach with the development of the downtown and wanted to understand or have a better sense of what the heritage or historical streetscapes were throughout Port Hope, including Mill Street and Queen Street, I think were referenced in the conversation. The discussion was related to at the committee member at the committee itself. I would suggest that the discussion was related to the capacity of the volunteers who are on that committee and their ability to do that research. I would point out that we have not brought forward a designating report to this council to designate properties. We brought a number of them in the last term, or at least certainly last year. And the reality is all of those designating reports are done via research through the volunteers on our committee. The reality is this is the kind of work that they do. They were certainly, I think they suggested they had the capacity to do so. The suggestion to the members of our committee, to the members of the committee, to both staff in our discussion were that, if the direction is of council to do this work, it would be appropriate for the mayor to, I can't speak on behalf of the mayor. She's not here today to speak to this matter. You'd have to ask her what her intention was, but certainly that was the conversation at the committee level. And that if we were to move forward in this fashion, we would need either a resolution from council or I would need to prepare a report to council to get direction from council to do this work.
Guess for me.
Thank you for that. And I guess, and it's unfortunate the mayor is not here today to speak about it, but I just wanted to express that it's a little disappointing, I would say, that we talk about transparency amongst this council. And I would speak for myself. I would not go to the environmental committee and move a new business there. I would bring it forward to council. So I just wanted to say that it's quite unfortunate it's coming this way. It's putting the cart before the horse, I think, to go to committee level at this, like this. But thank you very much.
Great. Any other members of council want to speak to this item? No, good. Then, yes, Councillor Clare.
I just want to make sure I'm understanding. So per the minutes, they're not proceeding with this work until they hear some direction from either staff or council. Yes?
They're not. So through the chair to Councillor Clare, I could say that they're not formally proceeding with this work until they received direction. They are volunteers. If they're doing research on these matters, that's certainly what they're doing with volunteer time. I couldn't tell you. I think, I would imagine hard to contain volunteers at times in this sort of capacity. So I wouldn't be surprised if they've done some of the research already as is of interest to them. However, nothing formally has been asked of them. I certainly, if I get direction from this council to move this matter forward, I think the cost is marginal and certainly within my spending limit, I would be happy to do so. So I would defer to council to give me direction to move this project forward.
Other comments from council? No. Brian, so to move this one forward, are we moving it to receive as information as noted? Is that how this goes now?
That's all we're asking for tonight. So we're putting committee minutes on our agenda. That's simply what we're doing. The minutes are a record of what happened at the meeting. All we're asking at this point is that they be received for information.
Okay, thanks very much. So I'm looking for a mover and a seconder to receive 4.2, the Heritage Port Hope Advisory Committee Minute Meetings of January 16th, 2023. Moving forward to, what's that? No, thanks.
Can we just back up one more?
For sure we can.
On 5.1 of their report, 65 Ward Street, what resolution are they looking to pass? I didn't understand that.
Through the chair to Councillor Andrews. So I believe at the conversation at that meeting, we received they received a delegation from a member of the community, Mr. Jenkins, who had some concerns related to the condition of the old hospital building at the on 65 Ward Street. My feedback to the members of the committee that committee themselves had exhausted all of the avenues related to that property. That property has been designated by the municipality. We had actually removed the this council, I believe, in one of its first acts, had removed the heritage demolition permit or rescinded the heritage demolition permit. And so my suggestion was that if this is an issue or a concern to members of the committee, the reality is the only thing that they could enforce, or that if they had concerns, were related to property standards. And so I believe that was the tone of the conversation. It was if it's in contravention of property standards, that would be the conditions under which they could deal with that matter. And I think the resolution is in fact to investigate or ask the appropriate municipal department to investigate whether this had contravened or was in adherence with the property standards bylaw.
Okay, I understand. Thank you.
Jason, do you want to speak to that?
Through the chair, actually, I had the conversation today with our bylaw enforcement team. A letter is going to be sent to the owner of that property this week in relation to contravention of our current property standards bylaw.
Thanks very much. Anything else on the Heritage Port Hope Minutes? It's a hot topic tonight. Okay, so the motion on the table right now is to receive it for information. I believe, Les, did you move that one? Okay, so can I get a mover and a seconder on that? Moved by Councillor Adams, seconded by Councillor Collins. Thanks very much. And all in favor? Great, thanks so much. All right, as we move into our regular standing committees, I will turn it over to the chairs of the standing committees to chair their portion of the meeting. We will start with Corporate Services, and I turn it over to Councillor Mink.
Thank you. Corporate Services is open. 5.1 staff reports, 5.1.1 report CS-02-23, Redocupet Dog Licensing Program, one, that a resolution be presented to Council to authorize the execution of an agreement with the Northumberland Humane Society to implement the Docupet Dog Licensing Program, and two, that a bylaw be presented to Council to amend the Animal Control Bylaw as necessary to implement this change. And I will pass it over to the clerk to speak to this for a minute.
Thank you, Councillor Mink. We are happy to present the opportunity tonight to modernize our dog licensing processes as recommended by our service provider, the Northumberland Humane Society. Docupet is a industry leader used by, I think, 45, that's what I recognized in the report, 45 municipalities in Ontario, including many of our neighbors. And Northumberland Humane Society, on our behalf, is looking to execute agreement with Docupet to provide that service for their contracted providers, being Port Hope, Alnwick, Haldimand, and the Township of Hamilton. We are happy to support that request. This frees up staff time as one benefit, but also, more importantly, makes the application process much, much simpler and accessible to the majority of our residents. Along with this change in provider will come a sort of fulsome communications plan, supporting the transition, publicizing the transition, and encouraging residents to license their dogs appropriately. We're not looking to change any of the current fee structure. We're looking to absorb the cost of the transaction fee related to credit card purchasing. None of the credit card information or financial information is captured by the municipality. It's all captured by Docupet as the provider. Quite simply, we look to see this improve the compliance numbers with relation to dog licensing in Port Hope. Compliance has historically been rather low. Through the increased awareness, increased accessibility, we expect our compliance to substantially increase. I'm happy to answer any questions.
Thank you. Can I have a mover and a seconder? So moved by Councillor Less. Well, okay.
Sorry, Chair. Either or, when you talk about non-compliance, absolutely appreciate it. So what is the plan to mitigate the non-compliance? So I see there's a cost factor here of, so there's two questions. I think it's 5,000 to be split between the various townships. How many do we have currently registered? And again, I can appreciate the cost, which is minimal. What is the plan then to mitigate this non-compliance? Just to say, we hope, I appreciate it, but what is the plan to mitigate the non-compliance? Because I would suggest to you, it's probably greater than what we have who are compliant.
I think you're right. I think the non-compliant members of the public are probably greater than compliant dog licensed, just given sort of average dog ownership across the municipality. I don't have the numbers in terms of last year's dog licenses. I do know historically it's in the sort of 200s, when you can imagine that there are quite a significantly larger amount of dogs in the municipality. So part of that problem is, as we've heard sort of regularly, with an annual calendar year based license, come June, July, August, you're basically gambling on the fact that you're not going to get caught. So I wouldn't suggest to you that animal control, sort of the enforcement of animal control in terms of dogs running at large, is significant either. But we do expect under this program, again, through that increased communication, increased ability, accessibility to the program, that our compliance numbers pick up. In terms of mitigating non-compliance, there's no change really with respect to enforcement. Enforcement's provided by Northumberland Humane Society. They are an agency that has a strong history of enabling that compliance, but we're not offering any suggestion as to how they go about increasing it more at this point in time.
Thank you.
Any other questions?
Well, let's not diminish the impact of the designer dog tags that you get with your license. You know, that's going to get some people signing up.
Any other questions from council? So could I have a mover and a seconder for this? Moved by Councillor Collins, seconded by Councillor Clare, and all in favor. That is everybody. So 5.2, new business. Is there any other new business from councillors before I read the library update? No? Okay. So I have a library update again this week, and we're going into March break. So there's a few items of interest on there to some people. So the board, first of all, the Port Hope Public Library Board meets monthly throughout the year. With the exception of July and August, all meetings are open to the public and are held at either the Mary J. Benson or the Port Hope Community Hub branch. And the agenda is posted in advance of the meeting date at the library website, www.porthopepubliclibrary.com. So if you are interested in attending, you're certainly welcome. There's lots of room. Have you heard about the Friends of the Port Hope Library? The aim of this volunteer-based support group is to further the goals of our public library in the community. Their focus is on fundraising, advocacy, and program support. These activities also often result in the enhancement of the library profile in the community and the further development of library services. The Friends is scheduled for March, annual general meeting is scheduled for March the 30th, 2023 at the Mary J. Benson branch. Guest speaker is Barbara Connor from the Peterborough Public Library Friends. The start time is 6:30 and all are welcome. So as far as programming, the library has an entire week of activities planned for children during the March break. Highlights include a Home Alone course for children ages 9 to 12 presented by Community Health Centers of Northumberland. Registration is required for this program. The afternoon is March 14th at the Mary J. Benson branch. And this is a free event, but you must register. String Games for Kids is taking place at the Port Hope Community Hub on Monday, March the 13th at 10:30. Drop by for a brown bag bingo from 12 to 1. On March 15th, also at the Canton Hub branch. Afterwards, there'll be an opportunity to visit the library to unpack the Lego collection or try out the gaming system. And experience Egypt with Laura Rainier on March 16th, suitable for ages 8 and up. The location is the Mary J. Benson branch at 2 p.m. And all of these activities are free. Don't miss the Blockbuster Experience pop-up from March 11th to the 18th at Mary J. Benson branch. Tour our Blockbuster, remember the video stores, display and borrow an 80s, 90s, or 2000s era movie with a chance to win a prize. And that's it from the library. And that is all for my agenda for corporate services. And I'm passing it over to Councillor Andrews.
Councillor. Vicki, finance is now open. I have no staff reports or new business for tonight. Are there any questions of council on my detailed report? Seeing none, I will turn it over to planning and development.
Thank you very much. We're going to sound similar. Planning and development is now open. We have no staff reports. We have no new business. Any questions from council for planning and development? Seeing none, planning and development is now closed. We'll send it over to Councillor Adam for Parks and Rec and Culture.
Thank you, Todd. Parks and Rec has no staff reports, and let's move on to new business. And I feel like we haven't said anything for a while, so here we go. March break camp is full, but we are accepting names to the wait list, and there's plenty of opportunities for swimming, skating, and the youth center gym drop-in also has opportunities. You can visit porthope.ca/recreation for their programs. The Town Park Recreation Center expansion giving guide has been launched as part of the community fundraising campaign. There is a call out for members for the Town Park Recreation Center expansion fundraising committee, as well as the 55 plus program committee. We are encouraging the community to participate. See the Town Park Recreation Center expansion page on our website. Also launched this week is the feedback survey for the older adults and seniors. The information gathered will help staff and the 55 plus program committee to determine new programming and opportunities for reopening schedule of the Town Park Recreation expansion. As most of us probably are well aware, the 41st annual Float Your Fanny Down the Ganny event is taking place Saturday, April 8th. On Easter weekend. Float Your Fanny. I don't think I really have to tell everybody what the Float Your Fanny Down the Ganny is, but it is a 10K race along the Ganarasca River to commemorate the 1980 flood and the devastation of Port Hope's downtown area. It celebrates the community spirit and resilience that rose in the face of this natural disaster. Now, Ganny Weekend is a whole vibe in Port Hope. Those looking to brave the frigid waters of the Ganarasca this spring are invited to visit the event website to review all safety guidelines and register a vessel. Race categories include canoe, kayak, and crazy craft. The Civic Award nominations are now closed, and thank you for everyone that has submitted something to the Civic Awards. We really appreciate it. They're all being reviewed, and the prep work continues for the Civic Award ceremony, which will be held May 4th at the Capitol Theater. That is it for new business from Parks and Rec from me. Do any counselors have anything to add for new business for Parks and Rec? I see none, so we're closing up Parks and Rec, and Counselor Claire for Works and Engineering.
Thanks, Counselor Adam. Works and Engineering is now open. We have no staff reports this evening. A couple of items for new business to mention. I had an opportunity to go out on Saturday early morning in one of our plows with Glenn, and got to see firsthand the challenges of dealing with heavy snowfall like we experienced overnight on Friday. And just wanted to note to residents who are concerned that the snow removal is ongoing. It does actually take many days for the crews to get through all the roads and the sidewalks and then deal with the snow piles. And so they are still working on dealing with the impacts of the snowstorm from Friday evening, and they will get to it in due time. I also wanted to put a save the date on everyone's agenda for the evening of March 23rd. In collaboration with the Environmental Advisory Committee, there will be a climate reality talk happening at Port Hope High School beginning at 6:30 p.m. And it's envisioned as a way to help, I guess, bridge the declaration of the climate emergency that was passed by this council prior to Christmas this year, and also to kickstart people's thinking going into the community climate action planning that will be launching in the spring. So I hope we'll see a big crowd there on March 23rd. Any other new business or questions from council?
When you were on your snowplow excursion, were there cars parked on the street?
There were a few cars on the street, not many, fortunately, but I certainly did see firsthand the problems that are caused when cars are parked on the street. Just noting that it requires the plows to lift up the side plow, which means they're not clearing the snow as effectively. And I was pointed out by Glenn that where there are trees along the side of the road, they're at increased risk of clipping branches and that as they go by as a result.
Yeah, I was just wondering how that meshes with thoughts of council about restricting, with new developers restricting parking in town and pushing more cars out on the street.
Good point.
Thank you.
Any other questions from council? All right, then Works and Engineering is now closed, and I'll pass it over to Councillor Chris.
Thanks. Protect Services is open. Staff reports, we have one, 10.1, 10.11, report PS0423, Enridge Gas. I'm going to call on Director Williams to educate us there.
Thank you, through the chair, Councillor Collins. The Enbridge Safe Community First Responder Grant Program considers grants to emergency response organizations that support communities within 20 kilometers of Enbridge Gas operations. In 2022, Port Hope Fire and Emergency Services made application to the Safe Community First Responder Grant Program, and in February of 2023, we were advised that we were successful in the grant application. This grant will provide funding to the fire service that will support purchasing of firefighter training and equipment to assist us in further supporting fire and emergency services in our community. This year, receiving a grant of $7,500.
Thank you very much, Director. On to 10.2, new business. There is no new business. Any questions from council?
Just looking for a motion from that last report. I think, yeah.
Got ahead of me. I was on a roll here. Thank you, Clark. I was trying to look at the looking for a motioner for that report PS0423 be received for information. Thanks, Councillor Andrews. Councillor Pearson, all in favor? Thank you. I'm already ahead. 10.2, new business. There is none. And I defer back to Deputy Mayor.
Great. Thanks very much. Then we will be moving into question period. Just a reminder for everyone, question period is for questions. Questions are to be directed to council. We ask that if you have any questions, you come to the mic, identify yourself, press the purple button before getting started, so make sure that the mic is on. Before we get started with, we'll start with councillors. Any questions from council? Councillor Clare.
I hope there's some questions from the audience because I'm in real danger of having to go put my kids to bed tonight, which I was not planning on. So I'm looking out there.
Just a reminder, question periods for questions. thanks very much. Any other questions or comments from council? No, wonderful. Moving on to media. Questions for media? No, seeing none. And... And now questions from residents. Yay. Come on forward. Press the button. State your name, please.
Good evening. I'm Deborah Walker. I live at the corner of Elgin and McCall in Port Hope. I'd like to know what the holdup is on the traffic lights. This is for Councillor Clare. The traffic lights at the corner of Rose Glen and whatever that street is, just north of the school there.
Croft Street, I believe. Croft. And I'm going to defer this to Director Davidson.
Thank you, through the chair. We are waiting for a computer chip. It should be received in the next few weeks.
Thanks, Deb. Any other questions? Seeing none. So that concludes our business to be covered on today's agenda. We have reached the end of our agenda for today. I'm in a position to adjourn this meeting at 7:26. Thanks very much and get home safely.